15th problem. Prove that sine pi by 8 whole to the power of 4 plus sine 3 pi by 8 whole to the power of 4 plus sine pi 5 by 8 whole to the power of 4 plus sine 7 pi by 8 whole to the power of 4 equals to 3 by 2. Okay, let us prove it. Now let us consider left hand side. So what is the left hand side here? Left hand side is sin pi by 8 whole to the power of 4 plus sin 3 pi by 8 whole to the power of 4 plus sin 5 by 8 whole to the power of 4 plus sin 7 pi by 8 whole to the power of 4. So let us note down left hand side value. So this sin pi by 8 whole to the power of 4 plus sin 3 pi by 8 whole to the power of 4 plus sin 5 pi by 8 whole to the power of 4 plus sin 7 pi by 8 whole to the power of 4. So in this problem, this is in terms of 5 by 8. Let us change this 7 pi by 8 and also 5 by 8. Let us change 7 pi by 8 in terms of pi by 8, whereas 5 pi by 8 change 3 pi by 8. So otherwise directly also we can change. This 3 pi by 2 can be written as pi by 2 minus pi by 8, and this can be written pi minus pi by 8. This also we can write in terms of pi by 8. Let us write it. This is sine pi by 8 whole to the power of 4 plus sine pi by 2 minus pi by 8. We can check it now. Here see, LCM is 8, 4 pi minus pi, 3 pi by 8, plus this can be written now sine 4 pi by 2 plus pi by 8. You can check it here. This is actually 4 pi plus 5, 5 pi by 8, and plus this can be written sine of pi minus pi by 8. So here also we can check it. 8 pi minus 5, 7 pi by 8 whole to the power of 4. So now here this is sine of a 90 minus theta whole to the power of 4. This is sine of 90 plus theta whole to the power of 4. This is sine 180 minus theta. Sine 90 minus theta is cos theta. Sine 90 plus theta is also cos theta. But whereas sine 180 minus theta is sine theta. So we get now sine pi by 8 whole to the power of 4. Plus this sign changes to cos, this we can write cos pi by 8 whole to the power of 4, plus this we can write cos pi by 8 whole to the power of 4, plus sin pi by 8 whole to the power of 4. Now adding these two, we get 2 sin pi by 8 whole to the power of 4 plus this we can write 2 cos pi by 8 whole to the power of 4. Now what shall we do now here? So now we can take 2 as common. Let us take 2 as common. Then we get sin pi by 8 whole to the power of 4 plus cos pi by 8 whole to the power of 4. Now you observe this step. If you observe this step, this will be in the form of a power 4 plus b power 4. See, we know that this a power 4 plus b power 4 can be written as a square plus b square whole square minus 2a square b square. This is algebraic identity. Using this algebraic identity, now this can be written as like this. Now 2 times sin square pi by 8 plus cos square pi by 8 whole square. Am I correct? This form. And minus 2 sin square pi by 8 and cos square pi by 8. Here, this is in the form of sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1. So, we can write now 2 of 1 square is 1 minus 2 sin square pi by 8 and cos square pi by 8. This can be written 2 minus 4 sin square pi by 8 and cos square pi by 8. Now let us see this 4 sin square pi by 8 cos square pi by 8 individually can be written 2 sin pi by 8 cos pi by 8 whole square. Let us write it. So this is equal to 2 minus 2 sin pi by 8 cos pi by 8 whole square. Now how does it appear? This is 2 sin a cos a formula. So we have 2 sin a cos a is equal to sin 2a. Sin 2a means here a for pi by 8. So sin of 2 into pi by 8 is this becomes sin 45 degrees. So this we can write now 2 minus sin 45 whole square, that is sin square 45. We know sin 45 degrees is equal to 1 by root 2. So this is equal to 2 minus 1 by root 2 whole square is 1 by 2. So 2 is the LCM, 4 minus 1, which equal to 3 by 2. Here see what is to be proved, 3 by 2, that is required value RHS. Hence LHS is equal to RHS.